Now what we're about to walk you through is the actual way in which you complete something. Like, now we're about to talk step by step by step what is required in the planning phase. Like, what does that look like? Now, here's what's crazy, see? I'm doing exactly what I envisioned to do. But here's what's ironic. C's vision, I didn't have a necessary vision, right? So C had the vehicle. Like, C was like, you're going to be number one in the world. That's the vehicle. And that vehicle has gotten me exactly where I wanted to be, right? Y'all got to understand what I'm saying. Actually, by making me a household name, it is easier to help people academically, personally, and professionally. If you go back and look at my mission statement that I wrote back in the day, it was to help people academically. Why? Because I had struggled in school. Personally, because I made some real bad decisions with my parents when I left home, right? And personally, because I felt like, anybody know ET, you know, I don't teach you professional development or personal development. That's what my life is, right? So what's crazy is CJ making us into a household name. Carl in those videos, and people like, yo, ET, do that when you want to succeed as bad as you want, breed that video guru boy. So guess what that allows me to do? Hit any school I want to now. I can go to any city and go to any high school. I can go to any juvenile city. I can go to any prison. Like, there are not many places I can't go. I can do NFL, NBA. And what can I do? I can help them personally grow. I can help them in their profession to go 120. And kids in school, I can help them academically. So see, that was always my goal. All y'all did was put me in a position where I can do it on my own terms now. And I can make money from doing it. But where did I take you? I took you to schools. I have literally blown up. And guess what, y'all? I'm doing more schools now than I probably did when we was first trying to do schools to make money. You feel me? What else? Church. I was taking y'all to churches. What are we doing? Same thing. We got our own now. You feel me? Nothing has changed. They had the vision. They had a tool that they were going to use. But all they're doing by making me number one in the world is I have the pick of the litter now. Man, somebody better hear what I'm saying. Reason why you can't do what you're doing, because you suck. The reason why you can't do what you're doing, because you average. That's why you can't. Me and you, the same thing. We got dreams and goals. By them making me number one, now I have the pick of the litter. I can go wherever I want and do whatever I want. All right, now let's talk about the plan, right? And I'm going to throw both of them in the mix because I need you to be able to see step by step by step. All right, so in one of our Sunday calls, Mustafa mentioned the habits of the most successful men in the world. One of the dudes that he mentioned was Warren Buffett. And he said that Warren Buffett blew up, not with selling products. He blew up. When you watch all the top dudes, none of them was on products. What you discover is that they all blew up investing in other people's products. Wow. Right? None of them, because everybody was trying to find out what's the biggest product seller that he had. He don't have none. Carl, I looked up Jay-Z's, like, not net worth, but when he became a billionaire, I looked at whatever. I ain't seen nothing about rapping. I saw him amass a fortune, Carl, through artwork. Like, art. Bro, I haven't even paid attention to that, but that's a part of, like, folks who are billionaires, like, that's a part of it. They invest in art. Now, I ain't gonna lie, I got a couple pieces, but I ain't never really been on it like that.
The good times photo don't count.
Oh, bro, it's gotta count for something. Are you saying because it's black it don't count? Is that what he's saying, Carl?
I don't know how much that good times
picture. You know what I'm saying, Carl? Is that what he's saying?
That ain't the kind of art we talk.
You feel me, Carl? I'll tell about anytime. Good time, anytime you need it, baby. Good time, anytime you need
it. I got a couple pieces.
You know what I'm saying?
That's how you know E making some money. Who taught you the word pieces?
You feel me? So I'm looking at how they're making their money, Carl. And so it's just like, wow. So then the first thing they asked Warren Buffett was, well, how do you decide who to invest in? He said, number one, I never invest in any company where the CEO don't show up every day. He like, yo, I'm not putting my money in. Nobody ain't showing up and going to work every day. So if it's somebody who got these crazy little things that they doing and they might blow up here, blow up there, but they not committed to showing up to work every single day. So let me tell you something. I'm already knowing we're on our way. Like, we already way further along the road, less traveled than when we started in 2006. Let me tell you something. The reason why I tell you to bet on us, because the first plan I taught both of them was show up every doggone day. That's the plan.
No, that's a fact.
Show up every single day. I don't care what we do. I don't care what we do. Like, I don't care what Carl does.
Yep.
I don't care what CJ does. But we got to show up. Who was I talking to, Carl? Oh, Fatai. She don't know me. So Fatai told Diddy she was hurt. Diddy said, what happened? She said, I stayed up all night putting up this slide presentation for ET, and then he got
she
on stage, and he didn't use any of it. Now listen to me. If the one thing the fellas would teach you that I taught them was, we don't know what people need every day. We don't. But what we know is when people come to the office, we need to be there. That's number one. And for some of you, you will not blow up. And you will not get to, the vision won't become a reality for you because you don't show up every day. You show up when you feel like it. You show up when, like, everybody eating together, everybody, whatever. See what, man, what? Bruh, you've heard them talk about a period where it's maybe a week or two. I don't even remember the time frame because I blacked out and I was going through it. So I don't remember the time where I was in the, but watch this. What you cannot say about me is even when I was going through my go-through, I was still at work.
Still there.
I was still there. I was still in the office.
Hey, the light was off, but he was there.
I was there. I'm talking about dead, like, but I was in the office. I wasn't dead at home. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
I wasn't dead. Nobody couldn't say that I didn't show up for work. Now, I'm not going to say out of 365 days that I'm going to be Mr. E, electronic, electrifying, you know, inspiring ET. But the first thing I taught them was we can't ask other people to take us serious when we don't show up. If we are emotional about our work, you can be emotional about everything else. But if you're emotional about your work, it means some days you're going to do it, some days you're not. You have to show up.